Hi, I'm Ming, and this is Kitchen Matters. We're a team of material science grad students helping you unravel the mysteries of food. Today it's time to pop the ultimate question. What is bubblegum made of, and how is bubblegum different from ordinary chewing gum? To answer those questions, we'll split this video up into three parts. First, we'll discover the composition of chewing gum. Then we'll discuss the flavor and texture of gum, and why those properties change as you chew. Finally, we'll discuss why you can blow bubbles with some types of gum and not with others. Chewing gum has been around for a long time, and many early civilizations were thought to have their own version of gum. These early chewing gums were natural plant products, typically harvested from trees. For example, the ancient Greeks harvested gum from their regional mastic trees, and it's also from the Greek language that we got the English word masticate, which means to chew. Nowadays, the chewing gum that you and I know isn't harvested from trees. Instead, modern chewing gum is usually made of synthetic, human-made materials. The main ingredient of chewing gum is the gum base, which is responsible for the chewy texture. Gum base is made from a variety of polymers, and you may recall that polymers are these long molecular chains composed of many small building blocks. In this video, I'm going to draw the polymers as these cartoonish noodles, which are all tangled up together to make the gum base. There's a variety of different polymers that are used to make gum bases, but what they all have in common is that they're very flexible, bendy molecules that like to be coiled up together. In a way, you can imagine the polymers in the gum base as behaving like a spring. When you bite down on chewing gum, you're essentially causing these bendy, coiled up molecules to flatten out. But when you release and stop chewing, the polymers coil back. This elastic property of gum base is what makes chewing gum chewy. All the other ingredients, like sweeteners and food coloring, are found scattered throughout the gum base. For example, there may be sugar for sweetness, and various other flavoring molecules like fruit or mint extracts. Another common class of ingredients are plasticizers, which are substances added to the gum to make it softer and more flexible. These are usually oil-based molecules, and you can think of the plasticizers as providing extra lubrication between the polymer chains, giving the polymers more space and freedom to slide over each other, which makes the gum softer and easier to chew. As an interesting side note, plasticizers are not unique to chewing gum. Many polymers in our everyday lives actually contain plasticizers to make them softer and easier to handle. For example, the polymer PVC is used to make everyday objects like bank cards and PVC pipes. PVC in its natural form is brittle and stiff. However, we can add plasticizers to make the material softer and more flexible, giving us such diverse items as garden hoses and household toys. That's the difference between a pipe and a rubber ducky. The same kind of polymer, but one contains plasticizer and the other doesn't. Back to chewing gum. We said that chewing gum is made of gum base, together with flavorings such as sugar and fruit extracts, as well as plasticizers to soften the gum. Now let's consider how each of these ingredients contribute to the experience of actually chewing gum. An important property of these ingredients is how well they dissolve in water. The polymers that make up gum base are specifically chosen to be highly insoluble in water, which means that they do not dissolve. In contrast, sugar and flavoring molecules generally have pretty high solubility and they dissolve well. Finally, the plasticizers are typically somewhere in between. Let's keep this ranking in mind and consider what happens when we start to chew gum. When we put the chewing gum in our mouths, the ingredients will first come into contact with saliva, which is mainly water. The saliva will first dissolve the ingredients with the highest solubility, in this case the sugar and the flavoring molecules. As we chew, the gum will lose its flavor because the sugar and flavorings get carried away with our saliva. Even after the flavor goes away, the gum still retains its chewy texture because the gum base and the plasticizer are still undissolved. You may have experienced, though, that after chewing gum for a while, it becomes firmer in your mouth, and that's because eventually the plasticizer also dissolves away. Of course, the gum base itself never dissolves, since the polymers are water insoluble, so that's why you can keep chewing forever. Nowadays, there are many companies working on creating long-lasting chewing gums whose flavors don't disappear so quickly. One technology for doing this is to encapsulate or cover the flavoring molecules in a water-insoluble coating. That way, the flavoring molecules don't get dissolved away in the saliva so quickly. In fact, there are material scientists working on this very technology today. Finally, to our third question. Everything we've discussed so far in this video applies to both chewing gum and bubble gum, but what is the difference between the two? What allows you to blow bubbles? To find out, I've gone ahead and bought some chewing gum and bubble gum from the store. Now I'm going to try stretching both out with my hands, and you can see that the chewing gum breaks pretty quickly, but the bubble gum is stretchy. Now, why do they behave like this? It turns out that the main difference between chewing gum and bubble gum is that the polymer chains in the gum base have different lengths. Here's a question for you. Between chewing gum and bubble gum, which one do you expect to contain longer polymer chains? Chewing gum or bubble gum? The answer is that bubble gum is made of longer polymers than chewing gum. Let's imagine the polymers in gum base as being like spaghetti. When we try to stretch the longer spaghetti strands of bubble gum, it takes some effort to untangle the strands and separate them. In contrast, the chewing gum is much easier to separate because the strands are shorter and they're not as tangled up. That's why bubble gum can be stretched further before it breaks. By the way, we should point out that this test I'm doing, where I stretch a material and observe how it responds, that's called a tensile test, and we do it all the time in material science. Now, what does any of this have to do with blowing bubbles? Well, when you try to blow bubbles, the air you're blowing out is essentially stretching out the gum base, just like when we pulled the spaghetti strands. Because the polymers in chewing gum are shorter, they aren't strong enough to stretch and support a bubble. However, the polymers in bubble gum are longer, and they are strong enough to hold together, allowing a bubble to form. That is, of course, if you have the right technique to blow it. Okay, time for a summary of what we learned today. Chewing gum and bubble gum are both made of highly elastic polymers, which gives the gum its springy texture. As you chew gum, the properties change depending on the solubility of the ingredients. The flavor is lost first because the flavoring molecules are most soluble and dissolve away. Then the texture becomes harder because the plasticizers dissolve next. And finally, bubble gum is made of longer polymer chains than ordinary chewing gum, which gives bubble gum the strength to hold an air bubble when you blow. Now, if you have a food you've always been curious about, email us or comment below. We'd love to hear your ideas as we continue our journey through the science of food. Till next time!